مجال للأسئلة. شكرا جزيلا.
Bahrain continues to witness a rollback of human rights. Since mid-2016, the Bahraini authorities have embarked on a systematic campaign to eliminate organized political opposition in the country. The main targets of this far-reaching repression have been human rights defenders, journalists, political activists, and peaceful protesters. Opposition leaders from the majority Shia population have been disproportionately targeted throughout. There is not one opposition political leader left who has not been detained, imprisoned, or stripped of Bahraini nationality. One latest development being the ongoing harassment, intimidation, and attack against former member of parliament, Osama Tamimi, who is known for his criticism of the government. Tolerance for free speech hit an all-time low, with an increased use of national security as justification for the prosecution and persecution of critics and dissidents. This year, the tactic escalated significantly with the King stating in a speech that he had directed security agencies to put a decisive stop to the misuse of social media. This heightened rhetoric of intimidation, which was supported and echoed by the Shura Council, the Prime Minister, and the Ministry of Interior, points to an alarming level of repression in the country, which is further exacerbated by the expanding ties between Bahrain and countries like the UK and the US, which often turn a blind eye to the grave human rights violations. The large-scale campaign of repression and persecution extends to prisons where prisoners, and especially political prisoners, face discrimination, harassment, ill-treatment, and medical neglect. Amnesty continues to receive credible allegations of failure to provide proper medical treatment. Those accounts and supporting documentary evidence paint a picture of frequent, ongoing, and in some cases, willful medical neglect in Bahrain's penitentiary system. In addition, the courts continue to hand down death sentences in cases of murder and national security offenses, often in unfair trials that rely on forced confessions. In one instance, the Court of Cassation this year upheld the death sentence of Muhammad Al-Arab and Ahmad Al-Malali. Both men were convicted of terrorism-related offenses following a mass trial of 60 individuals. The two men were tortured into signing confessions they have not even read. Our calls. Amnesty calls on the Bahraini authorities to stop harassing peaceful critics and ensure that Sheikh Ali Salman, Nabil Rajab, and all those detained solely for exercising their right to freedom of expression, association, or assembly are immediately and unconditionally released. Amnesty also calls on the Bahraini government to lift the vague and overly broad cybercrime and counterterrorism laws imposed to quash the right to freedom of expression and to annul legislation criminalizing the exercise of human rights, including criticism of the king. We also urge Bahrain to take immediate measures to fulfill its human rights obligations to all those held in custody of the state, to provide adequate medical care to prisoners, and to commute all death sentences and properly investigate claims of torture. Lastly, Bahrain's allies, namely the UK and the US, should pay heed to the consequences of the repression and pressure the Bahraini authorities to reverse their pattern of silencing peaceful critics, in which the persecution of Osama Tamimi is only the latest example. Thank you.